Those who lived through that era, this anniversary is even more special. A local woman who has seen the changes and lived through that history vividly remembers that iconic speech, and she's sharing her story with us. Alyssa Finsky has more.
We were off of school, and we all got to sit home in the living room and watch it on those little black and white TVs we had.
50 years ago, as Sharon Greer watched Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s I Have a Dream speech, she knew then it was a day to remember.
Just seeing that many black people all in one spot and no cops, you know, no one was being arrested. Everybody was being peaceful, and it was just amazing to see it.
For her and many others, it was more than just a speech about equality in a dangerous time of segregation.
Things were a lot different. We couldn't go some places, and some places we go and we were looked at like, why are you here?
It resonates with me particularly because I have two children. And I want my children to be acknowledged not for the color of their skin, but for the content of their character.
Reverend Martin Luther King Jr., a man who now symbolizes breaking down barriers for opportunity, ended up leaving an impact bigger than anyone could have ever imagined.
Dr. King was more, he was bigger than life.
I wouldn't have a business if Martin Luther King hadn't done what he did and said what he said.
It's the small details like Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard that remind us every day of the impact that the speech had.
That was Logan Street as I grew up. These are ways to honor him and make him remembered in everyone's lives.
In Lansing, Alyssa Fenske, Fox 47 News.
And we'll have more coverage of the I Have a Dream speech tonight on Fox 47 News at 10.